Okay, we're going to take a break from the walking step, the flat-footed walking step, which is the basic step for flat-footing, and I'll introduce the basic step for buck dancing. This is a buck dance basic step. All this really rural Appalachian tap dancing. That's rural. It's rural. It's tap dancing, but it's a rural style. I picked up this step from Thomas Maupin of Murfreesboro, Tennessee. Thomas is a famous buck dancer, and his protege, Jay Bland, broke it down for me. This is exactly 2.5 years ago. I'm going to do it really fast and then break it down and then do it with music. So the single step is this. It's like a 2-sound walking step. And then you add a double toe, it's like a 3-sound walking step. Too, and make it really, this heel comes down so you can make all kinds of sounds without any chug. Alright, so let's do that too. I'm going to do it too. Well, let me break it down first. So if you're doing this double sound, which is a one weight bearing step, it's an and one, and two, and three, and four. There's no real body movement except the slight left-right shift when you're dancing in taps. You can try this in leather. Your sound is always a little louder if your weight is over that foot, as opposed to all your weight being on this foot and trying to get a tap. So you have a little bit of a left-right shift. Left, right, left, right. The back foot's about halfway to the front, and you just take the weight only on the forefoot. It's your and one, and two, and three, and four. The front foot takes all the weight. When you get tired, you just switch. You could do a chug on that weight bearing foot and switch, or you could just switch sides. When you're just learning this, that's probably, if you don't know how to chug, that's a perfectly fine way to change sides. So you come in a little bit at this, a little bit as an angle. It gives you a little better sound than if you just did this. You come in a little bit as your weight comes onto it, a little bit from the side. Swings in almost like a side spank. And then you take a full step. And one, and two, and three, and four. Now, if I were to go for that parallel of the 3-sound walking step sound, I would double this toe. And I do that with a slight spank or brush forward. So you, and you, then you're, as you're coming down on this foot, you actively brush it and step. So your weight, slight rock onto this foot, brush, step onto this foot. Weight comes back to this one. This is fairly straightforward because there's no major body shifts. You can try that. I mean, if you have, it's easier again with tap shoes, this kind of dance. You could try it in leather. You want a good sound. Each sound should be fairly equal in volume. Switch. Let's try that to some Georgia Crackers music. This is a song called The Cat Came Back, sung by Kenneth Johnson. Good tunes. And Bonchi's gonna help. Alright. Good slow tune for practicing. Okay, we just do this 2-sound. Buck dance step, Thomas Maupin step. Double toe in. This is a 3-sound buck dance step. buckdance, so it'll be like this four sound buckdance set. Practicing beginning, but it's actually too slow. There's no room for me to add the heel, the fourth sound, for that step. So, but I think, in general, this is a great step to work on. It's very energy efficient, but also it builds up your shin muscles. For some reason, I don't feel that tired when I do the walking step. It doesn't, because there's so much other muscles and groups being used. This really isolates it, breaks it down to everything below your knees. Almost your upper body could be really still. That is what I did initially for the first week, just that to a metronome, and I got really tired shins. And I recommend that doing that, it'll start to help your buckdance step, but you'll find that it really increases your ankle strength. And I know it sounds crazy, but sometimes I'll sit under the desk and do this if I'm bored. You know, doing ankle circles increases your flexibility as well as strength. So does just up and down with your foot, straight leg, toe bounce like that. It'll actually build up your shin muscle, which is really, really important and helpful for you to do any kind of dance. Isn't that right, Bon Jovi? So.